Okay, guys, this is completely off the cuff. You know, it's not pre-rehearsed or anything like that. I'm just talking as shit comes in my mind. And the biggest thing that comes up that we hear in golf is this guy was the best ball striker to ever live. Mo Norman, you know, is up there. Ben Hogan. Well, he wasn't the best. I don't even know how they measure this shit. I mean, if you measure it by, I've won the most majors, you know, Jack Nicklaus could be deemed as the best ball striker that ever lived. If you go by that, Mo Norman was a good ball striker. He didn't win that many tournaments, and he sure the hell didn't win any tournaments here in the U.S. Who's some others that we look at? About Lee Trevino, one of the best ball strikers ever lived. How do you measure being one of the best ball strikers? You got to have a system that you have on those guys each and every time to take the measurements of how they hit that damn ball. Instead, we just say, oh, he was the best that's ever lived. I don't buy that shit. And the reason why I don't buy that shit is exactly what I told you. You got to be able to measure that crap all the time, because some of the best ball strikers that's ever lived really didn't live up to their potential as what we would think as the best ball striker that ever lived. Okay, if Jack Nicklaus was the best ball striker to ever live, hell, he should have won everything he entered. Okay, he did well. Don't get me wrong. But I'll throw this out to you. One of the best ball strikers to ever live didn't win a damn thing. He didn't win nothing. Why was that? Because they wouldn't let him play. Why was that? Because they saw something that he was doing that was so far above what everybody else was doing, they didn't want him to play. Y'all know who it is. If you don't, you ain't been around the block yet. That's the best ball striker that has ever lived. But again, even him, how do you know that when you don't have any metrics to measure each and every ball that he hit? So this myth that is being thrown around that this is the best ball striker that's ever lived, and people building systems around these people that are the best ball strikers that ever lived, is total hogwash, okay? What they're doing is selling you a method that they have taken, and they've looked at their swing, and they've looked at what they were doing, da-da-da-da-da, and all you're getting is a watered-down version of what that best ball striker actually did. That's what you're getting. You didn't get it from their mouth. So, anyway, in my opinion, there is no best ball striker. And that's beside the point. The point is this. If you're a golfer, you want to be the best ball striker that you can be, not who someone else is deemed to be. So why do we compare ourselves to these people? Why do we want to mimic those people when we're not them? Our DNA doesn't line up with them. Yet we go out there and we try, you know. You'll take Todd Graves, the one plane swing, natural golf. He knows a lot about the one plane swing. He's been around Mo, and he knew kind of what he was doing. But Mo wasn't the best ball striker that ever lived. The best ball striker that you should care about is not any of them. It's you. And until you get out of your comfort zone and find out what it takes for you to be the best ball striker that you can be, you're just shitting in the wind. And that's all I got to say about that.